Hi, I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. We have a couple of great questions this week. First, from viewer Mo Saidi, about his Mexican plum tree, which he purchased from a local tree farm in Fredericksburg and planted 2 years ago. Mo says the tree was beautiful the first year, covered in spring flowers. But after that, the new leaves that developed were deformed and would eventually shrivel up and fall off. We consulted Extension fruit specialist Jim Comas on this one and learned that the problem is a fungal disease known as peach leaf curl. The good news is that this is a leaf issue and it can be dealt with effectively by preventative sprays of copper hydroxide fungicide when the tree is dormant just before a bud break. In the early spring, watch for the tree to develop buds and then watch for those buds to swell as they start to grow. The time when the buds are swelling would be a good time to spray. Cool, rainy springs contribute to this issue, but if the spring is warm and dry, the spores are not as prevalent. The tree should grow out of this once the air turns warmer and drier, but growth may be stunted since the tree needs healthy, green leaves to photosynthesize and it will need to draw on carbohydrate reserves to produce new leaves. And from George Horn, who sent in this photo of a fruit from his Kieffer pear tree. Jim Comas confirms that this is quince rust, which isn't a common disease around here, but Kieffer pears are particularly susceptible to it. Jim suggests removing and tossing all of the affected fruit. Unfortunately, the fungicides labeled to treat this disease are not readily available to homeowners, so if this problem recurs, it might be best to remove the tree. Our plant of the week is Copper Canyon Daisy, Tagetes limonii. Native to the Sonoran Desert of southern Arizona and northern Mexico, this delicate-looking little perennial is actually quite tough and is very drought-tolerant. As with most desert natives, it thrives on heat and suffers if kept too wet, so good soil drainage is important. Plant in full sun and water sparingly once established. We've gotten away from calling any plant deer-proof, but the pungent fragrance of Copper Canyon Daisy's foliage tends to keep deer away. In ideal conditions, one plant may spread to 4 feet tall and wide or even larger, so resist the urge to plant them closely together. Bees and butterflies love the yellow blossoms of Copper Canyon Daisy, which typically blooms in late fall when most other plants are quite done with flowering. It may also flower in spring, but doesn't always do so. When blooming, the plant will be so covered in yellow flowers that you can barely see the deep green wispy foliage. As a perennial, all top growth will die back after the first frost, and the plant should be sheared to the ground in late winter or early spring to allow for new growth. If it blooms in the spring, you can also shear it back, but not to the ground, in early summer. Our viewer picture this week comes from Amy Acosta Welch, who spied this giant swallowtail butterfly cruising around her citrus tree, perhaps looking for a spot to lay eggs. We'd love to hear from you. Click on KLRU.org/CTG to send us your questions, pictures, and videos.